Our top story is from Santa Cruz County, where you had better get used to having your own reusable shopping bags and keeping them with you. Today, supervisors approved a ban on plastic bags. The new ordinance also imposes a surcharge on paper bags. But in an ironic twist, the new law could be delayed by as much as a year while they wait for an environmental impact study. We get more on tonight's top story from Action News reporter Phil Gomez, who's live in Santa Cruz.
Well, Aaron, since there's been opposition to similar plastic bans elsewhere, supervisors decided to conduct an environmental review of the new law before it takes effect in anticipation of any lawsuits. The EIR isn't cheap. It could cost as much as $100,000, although county officials hope to trim that cost.
Would you like to date paper or plastic?
In the future, it may be neither. Eventually, shoppers in Santa Cruz County will have to provide their own bags to take groceries home or pay a 10-cent fee for paper bags.
I'm in favor of people bringing their own bags to the grocery store and being able to bag their own product.
We have cloth bags all over the place. Why not reuse them? It's just a resource we have that's at our disposal, easy to use. You
just have to get in the habit.
That's one reason to make the switch. Here's another. Save Our Shores has collected 17,000 plastic bags during beach cleanup since 2007.
Once these plastic bags enter the ocean, there are several things that can happen when marine life encounters them. One, they can get entangled in them. They can ingest them or choke or suffocate on these plastic bags. All of these occurrences can lead to death.
But an environmental impact report would need to be done that could cost as much as $100,000, although board members believe it will be a lot less.
They just set aside that amount of money, and I think the implication was in case there's a lawsuit or case there are other challenges, I cannot imagine it's going to take that amount of money, especially given the work that's been done in other jurisdictions.
One grocery store owner is all in favor of a plastic ban, but would like to be included in the process.
I think they had some good ideas, and they're going to make some recommendations and stuff, and hopefully they'll come back to business and say, get our ideas, and we'll ask our customers and we can take that back to them.
And environmentalists say there is room for even more change.
It's not dealing with the bags you put your produce into. So they got to come back at some point in time and deal with that as well.
Now, the proposed paper bag fee would at first cost consumers a dime and would later be increased to 25 cents. The revenue for that money would go to retailers to support the new law. Aaron?
All right, Phil, thank you. Santa Clara County is also looking at banning plastic bags at area retailers as well. And while Monterey County doesn't have a ban on plastic bags yet, it is taking steps to save the environment by restricting the use of styrofoam. Today, the Board of Supervisors voted to regulate the use of polystyrene food containers in unincorporated areas of the county. The ordinance will stop restaurants and other retail food providers in these areas from using packaging, like you see right there on your screen. The ordinance will take effect on May 14th.